In this video, I'll explain how you set up and use the external terminals function on a CableEye HVX high voltage cable test system. In addition to the HVX tester you see here, I'll use a standard benchtop digital voltmeter to measure the output produced by the tester. Be aware that the HVX tester can produce voltages higher than most benchtop meters can take. Typically, that's 1000 volts DC and 750 volts AC. So be careful not to exceed these voltages with the meter you're using, unless you use a voltage divider to shift voltages down to an acceptable range. In general, you can use CableEye's external terminals function to check the insulation properties of two terminal components, like transformers, coils, or other components, and to confirm that the system is actually producing the voltages you expect. In this demonstration, we connect the external terminals output on the front of the tester to a Keithley Model 2000 meter using banana jack cables, as you see here. When you start the CableEye software in the usual manner, you'll see a screen like this, which we normally use when testing cables. To engage the external terminals function, first tick the box telling the system that you wish to engage high voltage. You'll see a black bar along the top of the screen summarizing the present settings for cable testing. Press the black button on the slanted front panel to enable high voltage in the system. This safety feature reminds the operator that high voltage will now be used as part of the next test, and exercise caution by not touching any exposed metal that is part of the cable, the device being tested, or the fixture. We'll now turn on the external terminals function by clicking this button on the left edge of the window. As you can see, a new control screen appears. You'll set the high voltage values, limits, and dwell time you wish to use in the central area of the screen. The test results and other controls appear on the left. I've previously set the system to produce 500 volts DC. You'll also see these test settings in the black bar at the top of the screen. When I start the test, the actual measured output voltage will appear as an inset in the lower left corner of the screen. To start the test, press the test button on the tester or click the start test button on the screen. Once started, the voltage ramps up to the set value, holds the voltage there for the dwell time, which I've set for 5 seconds, and then ramps down. Here it is again. The test results show that 500 volts DC was produced. We measured 50 microamps of leakage current, and when you divide 500 volts by 50 microamps, you come up with the resistance, 10 megohms. This is the internal resistance of the meter. Remember, we're not actually testing anything here. We're just measuring the output voltage of the system, and this particular meter and many like it have an internal resistance of 10 megohms. At the top left corner of the screen, you'll see a pull-down menu where I've stored preset values for different tests. You can use this too to set up different tests for different devices or different applications. So I'm going to now change this to 1000 volts. I'll click this, and I have a 1000 volt setting here. All works well here, and not surprisingly, the internal resistance of the meter again registers 10 megohms. Note that 1000 volts is the highest DC voltage value this meter can accept, although this model of HVX tester can produce as much as 2100 volts DC. Notice that I've set the maximum current to 105 microamps. I've also set the minimum isolation resistance to 9 megohms. If either of these limits were violated, the test will fail. To demonstrate this, I'm going to change the maximum current to a lower number. So when we have our roughly 100 microamp current flow for the 1000 volt test, we should get a failure. We do. So you see immediately the current and the voltage are stopped when the limit is exceeded. I'll change the current now back to 105 microamps, where it was a moment ago. And this time, I'm going to change the insulation resistance limit to 11 megohms. Now, because the meter we know is going to exhibit 10 megohms of internal resistance, this test should fail. In this case, it doesn't show you the failure immediately, but here you can see we measured 10 megohms, which is below the limit of 11 megohms we had set. We get a red block, an omega symbol, and a black X indicating that it's failed. As with any HiPot test, a device fails if either the leakage current flows at a higher level than the upper limit we've set, corresponding to an insulation breakdown, or the insulation resistance comes in below the minimum level we've set for acceptance testing. I hope you found this demonstration informative and encourage you to now try some of these tests on the external terminals function of your HVX tester.